all of you. You are watching News 7 North East. I'm Hunmudi Tisopi with the latest news of today. And now the news in details. One extortionist was shot to death in Kohima, Nagaland on Tuesday. One extortionist was shot to death by anti-extortionist team of Kohima police near the main town of Old MLA Hostel Junction Charge at around 4:30 p.m. Tuesday. An incident took place when police was trying to arrest the extortionist. He pulled out his pistol to shoot at the police. It has been reported that his accomplices were also able to arrest at the same time. Reporting from Dimapur, Hitoke Chopi with camera person Hika, News 7 North East. A fire against the four detained returnees who fled from the quarantine center JNV at Jaluki Police Station, Nagaland. Perennial police have registered a fire case at Jaluki Police Station against the four detained returnees who fled from the quarantine center JNV. The superintendent of Jaluki Police Station said to our reporter that a case was filed under the Disaster Management Act of Relevance Section IPC for violating the Government Act and intention to spread the viral disease which would be harmful to the entire society and state. Reporting from Dimapur, Hitoke Chopi with camera person Hika, News 7 North East. Four entry gate to Dimapur has been opened from June 24 onwards. The interstate entry was sealed in view of the current pandemic COVID-19, but now Dimapur administration has granted relaxation at four border interstate entry point. Along with Nagaland-Assam border entry point, the three entry point has included location are Borlengri Gas Junction, LRL Bridge connecting to Tea Garden and Ao Yim San entry point. Deputy Commissioner of Dimapur has stated that the relaxation has been granted for allowing movement of the people settled in the border areas of Dimapur for availing the essential commodities, medical facilities and education. Deputy Commissioner has also mentioned that registered during entry and exit thermal screening, masks and hand sanitizer were ordered as mandatory. Reporting from Dimapur, Hitoke Chopi with camera person Hika, News 7 North East.
It's an alert and awareness for the people of Nagaland State to stay safe at home that Nagaland State have reached up to 371 cases found positive, 211 are still found active and 160 were recovered and no patient has been released or found dead until today. The Health and Family Welfare Minister Pang Yu Fong will inaugurate BSL-2 lab in Dimapur on 27 June.
A good news to the people of Nagaland State that after much waited, finally, the Health and Family Welfare Minister Pang Yu Fong will inaugurate the BSL-2 lab in Dimapur, Nagaland on 27 June after an approval from Indian Council of Medical Research said during his interview on Tuesday. Reporting from Dimapur, Hitoke Chopi with camera person Hika, News 7 North East.
Violation in essential commodities price rate in Nagaland State.
From the several interview of the local people and shops owner, it has been reported that the prices of essential commodities was increased continuously and price of meat has surged up ₹300 per kilogram by the butchers on beef, pork and chicken despite the rate has been fixed by the Dimapur Municipal Council. The local people of Dimapur, Nagaland appealed to a district administration, the civil society GP's Consumer Rights Forum and Dimapur Municipal Council to monitor and implement strict rules and punishment of charging unnecessary prices on essential commodities. The local people had put a view that it would surely hamper and cause economic problems to the common people of Nagaland during this global crisis situation. Reporting from Dimapur, Hitoke Chopi with camera person Hika, News 7 North East.
And that's all for you in this edition. Thank you so much for watching News 7 North East.